Welcome to Seahawks Today by Chat Sports. I'm your host, Meghan Payton, and we want to keep giving you guys Seahawks content all season long. I've got a bet going on with my producer, Sam. We're trying to see how fast we can get to 30,000 subscribers. So help me out. Go subscribe right now to this channel so you guys can get free Seahawks content all season long. This video is presented by Magic Spoon. Magic Spoon is cereal that's healthy and tastes delicious. I'm going to tell you guys all about this, but go to magicspoon.com/Seahawks and get $5 off of your order today. We've got what we like to call our mailbag videos. This is where we take in all of the questions that you guys asked us in our community pages. We give you what our thoughts and responses are. Make sure you don't miss out on this next week. Just go to our community pages and let us know what you'd like us to ask and talk about on the show. Our first question for the day comes from Jonathan Sipkuti. He says, hashtag Seahawks. The current situation with DK Metcalf worries me. He's a great player, but I feel like he's becoming too much of a diva. Defenders are easily getting to him, to his head, and throwing him off his game and causing him to make penalties. What's your take on this? Do you agree? And Jonathan, I do think that there's some truth to this. I do think that we've seen DK Metcalf be a little sloppy this year. His emotion, I think, is getting to him, and that's going to cause problems. We're seeing those problems in the penalties. He was called for a taunting penalty against Colts linebacker Darius Leonard after Gerald Everett had that touchdown in week one. He had two holding penalties last week. He had a pass interference call, and also he had a false start in week one. These are not mistakes that you want to see out of a guy like DK Metcalf. So this is something that has to get handled, in my opinion. And I don't know what it is. Maybe it's the emotion getting to him. Maybe he's just dealing still with that injury, and this is kind of affecting his play overall. But Pete Carroll did talk about it in a press conference. He essentially just said, I think he's trying really hard. And it was happening in both games, where he's really trying to set the tempo and try to find the competitive makeup of the game. He needs to calm down a little bit. He was trying a little too hard. And I think that's a very nice way for Pete Carroll to say, like, hey, get it together, DK. And I don't think it's a huge problem, but yeah, I think that there's a little bit of diva-ish attitude coming from DK, and it's just not what you want to see. He's supposed to be a leader. He's supposed to be a guy kind of bringing the team together. So I don't like to see this, but like I said, he's dealing with an injury. So I think we should be careful to not necessarily take his diva-ness and translate it into his performance. I think that it doesn't, you know, help out or doesn't, you know, discredit the penalties and the emotion and the way that he's acting. But I think there are some other factors that are going into his performance. But on a scale of 1 to 10, how much of a diva do you think DK Metcalf is being? Go to the comments right now and let me know. Maybe it's a 1. Maybe you're like, hey, he's acting totally normal. There's nothing to be worried about. And maybe you're saying it's a full-blown 10. He is on diva mode and needs to get that handled. I'm guessing probably somewhere in the middle. To me, I'd say like a 4 or 5. A little bit concerning, but nothing too much to be worried about. Next question we have on our mailbag show today is from Marvel Geek. Marvel Geek says, should the Seahawks cut Tre Flowers? And I know you guys love to talk about this. We talk about it all the time. And I really want to like just say this. I'm not here to just dog on Tre Flowers constantly. You guys typically ask about him. So that's the reason why we bring him up a lot in the shows. But I will say, I defended him early on, and now I will say, hey, I think it's time to start exploring some new options. Do I think that we should cut Tre Flowers completely? No. In an ideal world for me, he would still be on the roster, but he'd be kind of taking on a role of like a backup corner. I'd like to have a different guy starting. I'd like to have a more experienced, kind of more consistent guy covering big receivers. I mean, we saw last week with Julio Jones. It's just, he's not the kind of guy you want on a team's top receiver. So yes, I'd say right now we haven't seen much out of him. He hasn't had an interception. He hasn't come really even close to an interception. Like I've said before, he's 10 yards off of a receiver a lot, and that's a problem. So yes, if it's up to me, I'd say it'd be nice to start exploring some new options. And like I said, this video is presented by Magic Spoon, healthy cereal that actually tastes good. I know it's crazy, but I'm telling you, it's real. I'm not lying to you guys. I am so picky, and this is my favorite breakfast. I gotta be honest, I ate this for dessert too. That's how good it is. It has 13 grams of protein. It has no sugar whatsoever and only 4 net grams of carbs. They've got a lot of different flavors to choose from. I'm eating frosted right now. That's my favorite, but they've got cocoa, fruity, blueberry, cinnamon, a ton of options. And if I were you, I'd get the variety pack. You can choose 4 flavors, try them all out, see what your favorite one is, but lots of options here, guys. Go to magicspoon.com/Seahawks. You're going to get $5 off your order today. I'm going to go ahead and finish my cereal. Next up on our mailbag questionnaire, we've got BatmanFan20. Batman, I'm pretty sure we answered one of his questions last week. I remember that username. He says, should the Seahawks trade for Stephon Gilmore? He actually wrote Stephen, but we'll forgive you. We know you mean Stephon. Now, here's where we talk about the cornerbacks. And now, if you're going to get rid of Tre Flowers or you're going to want to bring in a starter, who would that guy be? And yes, obviously, Gilmore is an amazing corner. He's someone that you would always want on your team. But is this the best choice for Seattle? I actually don't think so. I think you want a guy that's healthy and that you could play immediately. You don't want to bring in a guy, have to put him on the PUP list again and wait a few weeks to even play him, and then he has to adjust, get healthy. To me, this is not the best option. Stephon Gilmore is obviously a great player, but he is on the PUP list for at least another few weeks. The earliest he could come back is week 7. He underwent surgery on a torn quad back in week 15 of 2020. And he is in his final year with the Patriots, but this is something to me, I know a lot of teams had actually tried. I think, you know, I know the Saints were rumored to have tried to talk about trades with him. There's other teams that have wanted to pick him up, but the status of his injury is just unclear. And I'd like to wait, make sure he's healthy before any trade rumors come up with him. But maybe I'm thinking too short term. Maybe you guys are really kind of thinking into next year, the years after. Do you guys think the Seahawks should trade for Stephon Gilmore? If so, go to the comments right now. Type Y for yes if you like Gilmore on the Seahawks. And if not, type N for no. Staying on the cornerback trend for these mailbag questions, our next question comes in from HunterNano1611. He says, with the current situation at cornerback, do you think Seattle should try and trade future picks in 2022 or 2023 to get a better corner? Gilmore is on IR and will not be able to help this team. Xavien Howard is a possibility now that he has a better contract in Miami. What are your thoughts? So, you know, Hunter kind of says the same thing we were just talking about, where yes, obviously Gilmore would have been nice, but you know, he's on IR. It's not really going to be helpful to the Seahawks right now. He brings up a good point though with Xavien Howard. Xavien Howard. Obviously, Xavien Howard is one of the best cornerbacks in the league. Now, is this realistic? I don't think so. So yes, Howard would be nice, but it's not realistic in my opinion. If you just want a little bit of reminder of what happened with Xavien back in the offseason, he requested a trade from the Miami Dolphins. He was not satisfied because he essentially wanted more guaranteed money on the back end of his contract. They ended up negotiating a deal to where now he is going to get more guaranteed money. He's going to have his salary completely guaranteed next year. That's part of his signing bonus. And they're going to renegotiate and rework his contract out at the end of this season. So to be honest, I don't see him going anywhere. To me, this is unrealistic. Yes, it'd be great, but I think that the Dolphins are really happy with him. He is overperforming and really showing that he is worth the money that they are giving him. So far, just in 2021, he has had 7 tackles. He has had 2 pass breakups, 1 interception, and 1 forced fumble. And this is only expected to get better, in my opinion. And so I think the Dolphins are going to do whatever they can to keep him there. And I think the Seahawks would ultimately just have to give up too much if they wanted to get rid of him. And in 2020, I mean, just look what he did in one season. He had 51 tackles. He had 20 pass breakups, 10 interceptions, and one forced fumble. So it makes sense why he was kind of holding out and saying, hey, I want this contract to get figured out, and why he was requesting a trade. He said, look what I can do. And now he's proving himself. He got that worked out with the Dolphins, and I think he's going to end up staying there. It would be nice, though. Speaking of being nice, now if we're living in just this unrealistic world for a sec, if you guys could pick any cornerback in the NFL to join the Seahawks roster, maybe replace Tre Flowers for a few games, who would you guys want the Seahawks to have? Go to the comments right now and let me know your ideal corner. This is just the fun, unrealistic, doesn't have to actually be a real possibility, but want to know who you guys think the top corner in the league is right now. But for now, we are sticking with the current roster. The Seahawks are going to be sticking with the guys they have as of now. Hopefully some things change. They're going to be facing the Minnesota Vikings away. This is their first NFC conference game, so this is a big game. Right now, they're only favorited by 1.5. We'll see if that kind of changes as we get closer to the game. The over-under is set at 54, so this should be a little bit of a high-scoring matchup. I hope, I've said this before, the main thing that I think the Seahawks need to do to come up on top in this game is just keep the momentum going. We've seen how they can do in the first half, and if Russell can just keep the team and keep the momentum going throughout the whole game, I think Seahawks have a great chance of coming up on top. But who do you guys like winning this game? Go to the comments right now and let me know. If you think Seattle is going to win, type SEA. And if you're saying, hey, look, I think the Vikings are going to come up on top, that's okay. Go to the comments right now and type in MIN.